big game tonight. Are you feeling anything about just clinching at all?
You know, like I've said, you know, our goal is to try to get 50. So, you know, 8 games left to do that. I think that's exciting. But, you know, obviously, I think from a fan perspective, you know, it's a big night for sure.
What stands out to you to the length that this Minnesota team has, especially when Cat's back out there?
Yeah, I mean, they do a great job rebounding the ball. I think you look at last night's game, you know, especially their ability to, you know, hold a team like that, you know, under both teams under 100 points, you know, it's going to be a physical game. You know, for us, we really have to shore up the paint and just finish possessions.
You guys have had your heads wrapped around the fact that you'd probably be a playoff team, but to actually clinch it, how much will you celebrate this moment internally?
You know, I think for us, it's just a matter of just continuing to get better. I think, you know, when you, like I said, you know, we're trying to get 50, you know, we're going to have home court in the playoffs. So things like that, you know, it doesn't happen overnight. You know, it's been a long season for us. We've definitely had our ups and downs, so I think this is just another step in the right direction, but still a lot of work to be done.
What do you expect that scene to be if and when that happens tonight with the crowd and maybe the city?
Oh, yeah, I mean, it'll be crazy. I mean, it's going to be – I mean, I don't even know how to put it into words. I don't know what I'll see, but I mean, it's going to be nuts in there for sure.
Text up last night, you know, come on, dog.
Nah, man.
Did you watch that game?
I did watch the game, but no, I mean, like I said, it's always nice to be able to do that, you know, in a game where we have control over, you know, for it to happen. Obviously, if the other scenarios play out and it happens before our game even finishes, then that's out of our control. But for us to be able to, you know, have that moment at home in front of our fans, I think that's special.
How much extra pressure does that add to them?
I mean, it doesn't add any extra pressure for us. I think more so it's about us winning the game. You know, like I said, I mean, we could clinch without the game even being over, and then it could be mayhem in there, and then, you know, we could, you know, still have a game to go out there and finish. So I think for us, it's a matter of just doing that, making sure that at the end of the night, you know, it's a special moment, but, you know, we obviously get a win.
It does seem like business as usual in here, like no big deal, just another game night. What is your message, though, to the fans who have been here with you, the ride or dies through the ups and downs, through the 5 seasons that you've been here? If you could say anything to them right now, what would you say?
I mean, just, you know, eternally grateful for it. I mean, they're continuing, you know, sacrifice. I think you look around the league, you see players talking about getting booed at home all the time. And, you know, I think I've been here, you know, 5 years. I don't think we've ever got booed once. You know, just, you know, fans have always been loyal, super supportive. Been through this organization long before I even got here with the ups and downs. So, you know, for us to be at this moment, you know, on the cusp of making the playoffs, you know, it's just a lot of just gratefulness to them for just continuing to support us.
For as long as you've been here, too, this might be the most media attention you've seen surrounding your team this late into the season. How different is that, or an adjustment is that for you guys?
It's nice. It's nice to, you know, be able to look at the playoffs and actually see, you know, see the Kings there, you know, see us in the mix, see that, you know, we're not going to be going on vacation here in 8 games. So I think it's exciting for everyone here, but at the same time, you know, that's just – you know, getting to the postseason is just one step, right? You actually want to make noise. You want to win a playoff series. You want to, you know, go further than that. So I think we still have, like I said, a lot of work to do.
You mentioned the possibility of clinching during the game. Is there anybody around the bench that is paying attention or tracking that, or is that almost looked at as a distraction and you're not concerned about anything like that?
No, I mean, that'll be, you know, 15,000 plus that'll be watching that, monitoring that for it. I don't think anyone on our bench needs to do that. But it's going to be, like I said, I think for us, our focus coming in tonight is simply just winning the game. Like I said, we have 8 games left to go and, you know, make sure that we're right for the playoffs. So that's where our focus is.
What did you see from Minnesota last night in terms of their length? Obviously, length has been a problem for you guys in matching up. How do you see the Timberwolves?
I mean, they've been a tough matchup for us just in general. So I think that, you know, when you add Cat, a guy like that who can stretch the floor, it's obviously big. It's going to be a difficult game. But I think for us, as long as we just, you know, continue to stick to what we do, I think you know, when we did beat them, we were playing like ourselves. We didn't get slowed down, took care of the basketball. We played physical.